Hello everyone, I am Dr. Ruchira Prasad from Seth Padam Chand Jain Institute of Management, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar University, Agra. I am presenting my video on the topic Corporate Social Responsibility. This is my final video prepared for International FDP on Environment and Sustainability. The details of my earlier videos, my week one video was about the concept of corporate social responsibility, green CSR and sustainability. How these two concepts of CSR and sustainability are interrelated and the companies, how they are using their CSR initiatives for environmental sustainability. The number of views were 19 and the number of likes were 3. My week 2 video was about the different standards of CSR and the usage of triple bottom line for sustainability. Number of views were 200 and the number of likes were 89. After learning through video, students will be able to understand types of CSR spending by companies, new forms of green CSR, carbon footprint calculation, sustainability analysis through triple bottom line approach. Environmental CSR is the process to minimize the damaging effects on the environment. Key performance indicators of CSR can be energy use, water use, waste management, greenhouse gas emissions, and eco-friendly buildings. CSR initiatives can be described under three heads, that is social, which comprises of preventive healthcare and sanitation, education facilities, vocational skills, poverty and malnutrition. Economic can be human capital enhancement, ethical marketing practices in view of increasing potential consumers. Environment, we can manage the waste, water management, 3 R's, and renewable energy. Images of various CSR activities. Here we have the percentage spending of CSR activities, and the Act says that the total 2% of the net profit are to be spent on CSR. This figure shows you that only 12% of the total spending are done on environment, and 38 and 25% on education and healthcare hunger poverty respectively. But if the industries take care and increase the spending on the environment, the healthcare, hunger, poverty, education, these aspects can be taken care of, and the rural development can also be done in a faster way. So industry has to look to this aspect. These are the various standards: ISO 26000, Guidance for Social Responsibility, Organizational Governance, Human Rights, AA 1000, to check credibility and quality of CSR reports, to help organizations become more sustainable, ISO 14001, Pivotal Factors for an Effective Environmental Management System, which may be used for services as well as manufacturing sector, SGE 21, which talks about quality and environment, and enriched through multi-stakeholder vision. EMAS, voluntary initiative designed to improve environmental performance of organizations. International standards, ILO tripartite declaration, OECD guidelines, and UN Global Compact. Here is the India's emission of greenhouse gases, which are very harmful, for hazardous for the environment and the people. Greenhouse gases comprise of carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, methane, etc. From this figure you can see that the maximum emission is from energy sector and then from various other industries, that is 19.9%, then agriculture and waste. So India has to work upon so that the emission from the energy and industries can be reduced to a much lower extent. This graph gives you the per capita greenhouse gas emission. From the graph you can make out that for the last 10 years, India is the increase is very negligible, but India has to work upon reducing this emission per capita greenhouse gases emission, which has not been done so far. Carbon footprint is basically the amount of total emissions done by an individual, event, organization, any process or product. It can be expressed in terms of carbon. It is a quantitative expression of GHG emissions from an activity and is helpful in the management of various emissions and evaluation of the measures of mitigation. This can be done by various human activities like usage of electricity, transportation, water purification gadgets, and manufacturing processes. Various methods have been given for carbon footprint calculation. Here we are using life cycle assessment method. These are the proposed CSR activities which can be done by the organization. Plantation of trees is a very integral part of organizations, but if we focus more on those type of trees which use come lesser water and that can be helpful in employment generation. So bamboo trees can be one of them in which water usage is less, and we can train the people to make various products out of bamboo and they can be a source of livelihood. Mass management, fragrance industries, their waste is dumped in various hills, and due to rainfall and river rainfall and wind, these musks are flown away and they pollute the river streams. With the help of gram panchayat heads or village heads, the industries can manage this musk and help the environment. Charity of vehicles can be done in the form of green vehicles which can be environment friendly. Toilets being established in rural areas, that can be in the form of bio toilets or sulabs, in which the wastage of water is very less and the maintenance is also very low. Life cycle assessment method for calculation of carbon footprint helps us in the following areas. We can compare existing products with theoretical alternatives, estimation of environmental impact of a product over its entire lifespan, target carbon emission of individual stages of the product life cycle. Here I have calculated carbon footprint from motorized vehicle. Suppose a person owns motorcycle who consumes 4 liters in 100 km and he drives 500 km, so he consumes 20 liters. Per liter carbon dioxide emission for petrol is 2.7 kg, so 54 kg of carbon dioxide is emitted. And if the person travels 15,000 km in a year, the total carbon emission will be 1620 kg. Approximately. And if the lifespan of vehicle is 10 years, then the total emission by the vehicle will be 16,200 kg of carbon emission. And if we distribute e-vehicles, this can be saved. Sustainability analysis, the tool used for analysis is triple bottom line approach, which is given by Elkington. First parameter is profit. Profit talks about the income statement and about the benefit of the stakeholder or the host. Then comes the people. This is the social bottom line of this triple bottom line approach. And then the planet or the environment bottom line, which talks about the environment approaches of the industries. The framework of TBL, this profit aspect talks only about income statement. Environment aspect measures impact of business activities on environment, evaluate emissions and uses of sustainable inputs. And the people aspect, this is the social responsibility. The parameter cannot be quantitatively calculated, but qualitatively you can see how the people have been developed. The living standards have been improved. The outcome of triple bottom line can be these: profit, people and planet together can encourage businesses to think beyond profit. They can encourage CSR reporting. They can support measurement of environmental impact and sustainability. Now to conclude, we can say that CSR is mandatory for all organizations. but the guidelines are mostly with regards to the stakeholders of the organization, that is people and profit. The amount of spending on the planet part through CSR activity is very less. So the form of spending can be modified so that it will be helpful in prevention of the environment. The TBL model suggests that if we balance all the three aspects, that is people, profit and planet, then the sustainability of the organization will improve and the organization will be able to achieve its profit motive and social motive in a better way by looking at the planet. Thank you so much.